Myself, Dr. Kaushlendra Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of B.Ed, RMLA PG College, affiliated to Banaras Hindu University. Today, we will discuss about constructivism and 5E model of learning. The key points of this presentation includes basic concepts of constructivism, guiding principles behind constructivist theory, characteristics of constructivist learning, and 5E model of learning. First of all, we will discuss about basic concept of constructivism. What are the basic concepts behind constructivist learning theory? Constructivism is basically a theory based on observation and scientific study about how people learn. It says that people construct their own understanding and knowledge of the world through experiencing things and reflecting on those experiences. When we encounter something new, we have to reconcile it with our previous ideas and experience, maybe changing what we believe or may discard the new information as irrelevant. Here, one point is very important to notice, that is previous knowledge of a learner. The whole theory of constructivism is based on previous knowledge of a learner or a student. Constructivism is an epistemology or a theory used to explain how people know what they know. This is very important point regarding constructivist theory. Here the learner came to know how, what is the knowing process or how he know new things. The basic idea is that problem solving is at the core of learning, thinking and development. As people solve problem and discover the consequences of their action through reflecting on past and immediate experiences, they construct their own understanding. Learning is thus an active process that requires a change in the learner. This is achieved through the activities the learner engages in, indulge the consequences of those activities, and through reflection. People only deeply understand what they have constructed. Constructivism is a philosophy of learning founded on the premise that by reflecting on our own experiences, we construct our own understanding of the world we live in. Each of us generate our own rules and mental models, which we use to make sense of our experiences. Learning, therefore, is simply the process of adjusting our mental models to accommodate new experiences. Now we will discuss about guiding principles of constructivism, or we can say that what are the principles on which constructivist theory is based on. Learning is a search for meaning, therefore learning must start with the issues around which students are actively trying to construct meaning. Here meaning requires understanding wholes as well as parts. Parts must be understood in the context of wholes. We can't understand part knowing whole or whole without knowing parts. Therefore, the learning process focuses on primary concepts, not isolated facts. This means that we construct our own knowledge regarding all parts through which it is constructed. In order to tell, in order to teach well, we must understand the mental models that students use to perceive the world and assumptions they make to support those models. The purpose of learning is for an individual to construct his or her own meaning, not just memorizing the right answers and regurgitate someone else's meaning. Since education is inherently interdisciplinary, the only valuable way to measure learning is to make the assessment part of learning process, ensuring it provide students with information on the quality of their learning. What are the basic characteristics of constructivist learning? Now we will discuss about the fundamental or basic characteristics of constructivist learning theory. Goals and objectives are derived by the student or in negotiation with the teacher or system. Here, role of student is important as well as teacher role is very important in deciding the aim of education. multiple perspectives and representations of concepts and content are presented and encouraged. Teachers serve in the role of guide, mentors, coaches and tutors, and as a facilitators. Activities, opportunities, tools and environments are provided to encourage metacognition, self-analysis, regulation, reflection and awareness. The student plays a central role in mediating and controlling learning. Learning situations, environments, skills, content and tasks are relevant, realistic and authentic and represent the natural complexities of the real world. Primary sources of data are used in order to ensure authenticity and real world complexity. Here, constructivist learning process focuses on primary data, means the learner or student collect or observe the data himself or herself. Knowledge construction and not reproduction is emphasized. This construction takes place in individual context and through social negotiation, collaboration and experience. The learner's previous knowledge, constructions, beliefs and attitudes are considered in knowledge construction process. Problem solving, higher order thinking skills and deep understanding are emphasized. Errors provide the opportunity for insight into students' previous knowledge constructions. Exploration is a favored approach in order to encourage students to seek knowledge independently and manage the pursuit of their goals. Knowledge complexity is reflected in an emphasis on conceptual interrelatedness and interdisciplinary learning. Collaborative and cooperative learning are favored in order to expose the learner to alternative viewpoints. Assessment is authentic and interwoven with teaching. Here, assessment is continuous throughout the learning process. Each and every step is assessed by the evaluator or teacher in order to encourage the learner to do more accurately or more well in their learning process. Now we will discuss about the 5E model of learning. These 5E model includes engage, explore, explain, elaborate and evaluate. These are the 5 E's. Now we will discuss one by one these 5 E's. First of all, the first E is engage. In this stage, the teacher can create interest and generate curiosity on the topic of study, raise questions and elicit responses from the learners that will give an idea of what they have already known. The activities in this stage capture the learner's attention, stimulate their thinking and help them assess their prior knowledge. The learners first encounter and identify the task. Here they make connections between past and present. Learning experiences lay the organizational groundwork for the activities ahead and stimulate their involvement in anticipation of these activities. During this stage, the learner should be asking questions, why did this happen or how can I find out? Next step is explore. In this stage, learner are given time to think, plan, investigate and organize collected information. The learner should be given opportunities to work together in groups without direct instruction from the teacher. They get directly involved with phenomena and materials, involving themselves in these activities. They develop a ground experience with the phenomena to be learned. As they work together in groups, they also build the base of common experience that assist them in the process of sharing and communicating with each other. The next point is explain. At this stage, the teacher may also provide definitions and explanations if required. For example, a learner may through his or his, her explanation may state that they have noticed that a magnet has a tendency to stick to a certain metallic object. The teacher at this stage might introduce the term attracting force. Introducing labels after the learner has had direct experience is far more meaningful than before that experience. Elaborate. During this stage, the learner expand on the concepts they have learned, make connections to other related concepts and apply their new understandings in new but similar situations and use formal labels and definitions. For example, while exploring light phenomena, a learner construct an understanding of the path light travels through space. Examining a lamppost, the learner may notice that the shadow of the post changes its location as the day grows later. This observation can lead to further inquiry as to possible connections between the shadows changing locations and the change in the direction of light source, the sun. Last step of 5E learning is evaluate. Learners should assess their own learning through reflective experiences. Peer assessment can also play a role over here, wherein the performance of one group may be assessed by the other group, or one may assess the performance of the other depending upon the kind of tasks and the context of learning. The teacher may observe and assess the learners continuously throughout the learning experience. The knowledge, skill, application of new concepts and change in thinking may be observed and assessed. It is an ongoing diagnostic process where the teacher gets picture of learner's understanding of concepts and knowledge. Now, we will discuss about the role of teacher and students in these 5 steps. First step in engage, the role of a student is to encounter and identify the instructional task, concept, connect past and present learning experiences, plan organizational groundwork for activities. Here in the step of engage, role of teacher is to stimulate students involvement in anticipation of activities, asking a question, defining a problem, showing a surprising event, acting out a problematic situation, demonstration, or reading from science journal articles, newspapers. In the next stage, explore. Here the role of student is, a student directly get involved with phenomena and materials, work together in teams, build a base for common experience which assists students in process of sharing and communicating. Inquiry process, solve a problem, construct a model, experiments, design and perform. The role of teacher is, he acts as a facilitator, providing materials, guiding towards focus. In the next step, explain. The role of a student is, a student began to put the abstract experience into communicable form. Communication occurs between peers, facilitators, or within the learners himself. Students support each other's understanding as they articulate their observation, ideas, questions, and hypotheses. The role of teacher in explain part is, he can provide names that correspond to students' findings. He can determine levels of understanding and possible misconceptions. He can record the evidence of learners' development and process, which include writing, drawing, video, or tape recordings. The next step is elaborate. The role of a student is, he can expand on the concepts learned, make connections to the related concepts, apply the understanding to the world around them. The role of teacher in the step elaboration is, the learner may be reminded about the alternative explanations and to consider existing data and evidences as they explore new situations. The last step in the 5V learning is evaluate. Here the role of student is self-assessment that involves reflecting process on the task or the learning attained, peer assessment, revisit the concept misconceived which is identified through self-assessment and reflective thinking. A student refocusing the investigation, plans and maintains a portfolio which shows the best accomplishment of the task performed and assessed by self, peer group and teacher. The role of teacher in the evaluation process is ongoing diagnostic process. The teacher determines if the learner has attained understanding of concepts and knowledge, tools to be used by the teacher in the process of evaluation is observations, checklist, interviews, portfolios, projects, problem-based learning products. These tools may be used in the process of evaluation. Teacher displays of attainments and the progress of students. Evidence of learning guides the teachers. Thus, today we have learned about the basic principles of constructivism. What are the guiding principles of constructivism? 5V model of learning and the role of teacher as well as student in these 5V model of constructivist learning. Thank you.